I think Iran is a threat. I think it's a very big threat. And I think I did a great thing when I terminated the ridiculous Iran nuclear deal. It was a horrible one-sided deal that was $150 billion plus $1.8 billion in cash and lots of other bad things. If you remember, they took our 10 sailors out of waters that people are disputing and made us look very bad. But, of course, the payment was due the following day, so they eventually let them go, which they had to. I disagree very much on that. I also think, and you'll be seeing something next week, because you look at what's happened in Syria with respect to ISIS and the caliphate. We took over a lot of area in the last 2 weeks. We've done tremendous in the last couple of weeks. At the same time, we're consolidating, and a tremendous amount of good things are happening. You even look at what's going on, and I can't tell you that this is a guarantee, because we're going into close to 19 years in being in Afghanistan. And for the first time, they're talking about settling. They're talking about making an agreement. And we bring our people back home. If that happens, we'll see what happens. But they're in very serious negotiations for the first time. There's a reason for that. So I think we're doing so well on a foreign policy basis. You look at North Korea. Many of you are going to be traveling with us to North Korea. And for the meetings with North Korea, we're going to a certain location. I think most of you know where the location is. I don't think it's any great secret, but we'll be announcing the location and the date, the exact date. It'll be the end of February. And we've made tremendous progress with North Korea. When I came in, or let's say at the end of the last administration, frankly, it looked like we were going to war with North Korea. Now, there's no missile testing. There's no rocket testing. There's no nuclear testing. We got back our prisoners or our hostages, and we're getting back our remains. They're coming in. And we've had some beautiful ceremonies in Hawaii, other places. So I just tell you that we are doing really well. Our military is being rebuilt. It's very close to being rebuilt. We have tremendous amounts of new aircraft, new ships, new weapons of all kinds, which we need, because hopefully the stronger we get, the less you have to use it. I guess you know that from growing up in school. The stronger we are, the less we're going to have to use it. We don't want to have to use it, but we're going to have the strongest military by far that we've ever had. So I didn't see the report from the intelligence. When you read it, it's a lot different than it was covered on in the news. But I think that Iran is somebody, is a nation that we have to watch very closely. They sent up a rocket the other day, and it failed, but it was sent up. Now, they can say they're sending it up for civilian purposes, but I don't think too many people believe that. They're doing tests, and we don't want to be in a position where we're behind. We're not going to be leading from behind anymore.